Okay, that is our slide, which is industrial control system. Okay, so as you know, control system is actually a subject which consists, which makes a link between the industry and the study and the engineering fields. Okay. So this kind of subject is control system. So today I would like to show you some thing about industrial control system. Let me show you. Okay. So first of all, what is a basic control system? So an automatic controller compares the actual value of the plant output with desired value. See, look at the first line here. Okay, look at the first thing here. An automatic controller compares the actual value of the plant output. So what is the actual value of the output with the desired value, determines the deviation and produces a control signal which will reduce the deviation to zero or to a small value. That means, what does it mean? That means if you want the output, then you have to check by using the feedback, you have to check the output and compare it with the input. Whenever you achieve the desired goal, then it will stop. That means the automatic controller, what it does, it actually compares the input with the output. Okay. So, and it determines the deviation. What is the deviation? It produces the control system and control signal according to your deviation. Okay, so it is the basic control system. The manner in which the automatic controller produces control signal is called the control action. This is known as the control action. The manner in which the automatic controller produces the control signal is known as the control action. So if I ask you about the control action, then what would be your answer? And your answer would be, the manner in which the automatic controller produces the control signal is called the control action. Okay. And classification. There are some classifications of industrial controllers. Almost six types of controllers are there. And industrial automatic controller may be classified according to their control actions as, I'll show you some YouTube video after the lecture, after this slide. Classification, some classifications like two position or on off controller. One classification is two position or on off controller. That means zero or one. If you can get the zero, then it would be off. If you get the one, then it would be on. Okay, so that is the two position or on off controller. That means, yes or no. Okay. Second one is proportional controller. It is another type, you'll see later. Integral controller. Proportional means the P controller. Integral control means the I controller. Proportional plus integral controller, PI controller. Proportional plus derivative controller, PD controller. Proportional plus derivative plus integral controller, EID controller. So these are the controller we have to look at. One is EID, another one is PD, another one is EID. Okay, three controller are there. PI, PD, and PID. These are the main controller actually. And this controller, PID controller, mostly used in the control system applications. Okay, so mostly we do use the PID controller. That is one, this one. Proportional plus derivative plus integral controller, PID controller. Okay, so PID controller, proportional plus integral plus derivative controller. So it is the PID control.
Okay, sir.
So PID control is very important for this time. Elements of an industrial automatic controller. So, what are the elements of the automatic controller? See, an automatic controller must detect the error. So, it must detect the error. Comparator may be used for this purpose. See, comparator means what? It will compare the signal to signal. That is the comparator, purpose of comparator. The controller normally operates at low voltage. The controller normally operates at low voltage and low power level. So amplifier is required. See, the controller normally operates at low voltage. The voltage will be lower and the power level will be lower. So amplifier will be required. The measuring element measures the control variable of the fan. And the measuring element will measure the control variable of the fan. Block diagram of automatic controller, reference input, error detection, actuating error. So controller amplifier means say it will go to the actuator, and measuring element it will come from the plant. Okay. So you are putting the input, reference input, and you are getting the error detector signal from the plant, and the control amplifier it will send to the actuator. See, the controller normally operates at low voltage and low power level, so amplifier is required. So amplifier will amplify the voltage level as well as the power level. That is why we need an amplifier. And measuring element measures the control variable of the plant. Measuring element will measure the control variable of the plant. Okay. The two position or on off control connection. This controller is very simple. In express sine wave and widely used for industries and domestic applications. What it does, it does the error signal to produce the control action. The controller produces MT from the input error signal ET. The two levels on off signal is produced by the controller. Wait. MT is equal to M1 for ET. For ET is greater than 0, and MT is equal to M2 for ET is less than 0. See. Whenever it is higher than 0, it would be M1. Whenever it is less than 0, it would be M2. So two things are there. One is M1 and another one is M2. Okay, M1 and M2. Two positions are there. What that means, we are talking about the on-off control system. There are two kind of signals are there. Two kind of signals are there, M1 and M2. It would be M1 whenever the value would be higher than 0, and it would be M2 whenever the value is lower than 0. Okay, things are there. Now see, that is the reference input. Here is the M1 and here is the M2. So M1 is the 0. M2 is higher than 0. See, M1 is lower than 0 and M2 is higher than 0. Two levels without differential gap is used, and a differential gap, or resources used to effort frequency. Now another one, the proportional controller. The proportional controller here, for a proportional controller, MT is equal to TPE, or the output of the controller is proportional to the input. See, by using Laplace transform, MS by S is equal to KP, where MS by S is equal to KP. The problem of this controller is, if it is zero, MT is also zero. This controller requires steady state error to operate. It provides no delay, and the steady state error can be reduced to a very low value by setting high value of KP. So see, here if it is equal to zero, the whole thing would be zero. The MT would be zero. Okay. So, and here to maintain, to reduce the error, we have to increase the value of KP. Okay, so we are very careful about the KP, and we have to increase the value of it. So MT is equal to KPET. Okay, so here if you put the ET, that is the error signal is zero, if error signal is zero, then the MT would be zero. And to make the standard value of MT, we have to increase the value of KP. Okay, we should be careful about this. Okay. Now, integral controller. It integrates the error to produce the output. KI, integration of ETDT or MS is equal to KI by S. It introduces a pole at origin. So in the integral controller, it gives a pole at origin. It is a slow controller as it introduces the error. It is a slow controller. Do you understand what is the integration? That means you are joining many things, integration. You have, say, five pieces of paper. Okay, five pieces of rope. If you join one rope with another, if you tie one rope with another, then you are doing the integration. Okay, so integration means you are integrating many things. Same kind of things. You are integrating the same kind of things, that is the integration. On the other hand, differentiation means you are splitting the things. Restricting the things in the differentiation, and you are integrating the things in the integration. Okay, two things are there. One is integration, another one is differentiation. Yeah. Integration and differentiation.
Hello, sir.
Okay, do you understand? So it is a slow controller. Okay, so it is a slow controller as it prepares the error. And it produces a ramp output with a step error input and parametric output the ramp error. So that means some error are there. So it is a slow controller. It is slow controller as it is there. It produces the ramp output with the step error input and the parabolic output the ramp error. A few things are there. And derivative error. What is the derivative error? It differentiates the error with error signal to produce the output. It differentiates the error signal to produce the output. The differentiate and the derivative error is d by dt of ct. And MS is the KBS. It is the error constant. So it converts step error to impulse output, ramp error to step output, and parabolic error to ramp error. And the controller produces fast response. So see, previous one, integral controller, it produces the slow response. On the other hand, the derivative controller producing the fast response. Two things are different here. One is producing slow response, and another one is producing the fast response. And in the derivative controller, the pole generates the controller generates a zero at the origin. On the other hand, in the integral controller, the integral controller generating the pole at the origin. Two things. If I ask you to differentiate between the integral controller and the derivative controller, I think you'd be able to explain those topics. Okay, what is the integral controller and what is the derivative controller? Two things are different. Okay, one is producing the pole at the origin and another one is producing zero at the origin. Integral controller has slow response, slow controller, and derivative controller is a fast controller. Okay, a few things are there. Now, another one, which is the PI controller. PI controller is one of the most widely used controller. It combines the benefits of both proportional and integral controllers. See, what it does, it combines the benefits of both proportional and integral controllers. So we already have seen the proportional controller functions and integral controller function. Okay. So those are, we are taking the benefit of this. Proportional controller, KT into PT, and the integral controller, KI, integration of PT. And if you take the Laplace transform of this, AP plus AI by S into X, if you take the S common. Or we can say that AP is 1 plus S here by S. Okay. Because instead of AI, you can write this. It introduces a pole and a zero to the controller system. So if you do use the PI controller, then it will introduce a pole and a zero in the controller system. Okay. So it is another kind of controller which is widely used in the world, which is most widely used controller. It combines the benefits of both proportional and integral controllers. And T is equal to KPET plus PI integration of ETBT. This will be KP plus K by S into S, is KP into 1 plus K by S into S. It introduces a pole and a zero to the controller system. And the other one is PD controller. The output of the controller is MG is equal to KP ET plus KD into DDT of PD. PD, that means proportional and derivative. So we are considering proportional controller and the derivative controller all together. So the equation is nt is equal to kp of dt plus kd into d by dt of dt. Now what I can write, ms is equal to kp plus kds into s into kp 1 plus ds into s. So it introduces zero and is zero and is used in applications for very fast control system. So it is used in the very fast control system. PD is used in a very fast control system. PD controller. Now we'll go to the PID controller. What is this? It is actually the most versatile form of controller. And it combines the features of the of these controller components: proportional, integral, and derivative. Three controller are all together. Okay, so it introduces two zeros and a pole. This is the most versatile form of controller, and it combines the feature of the of these controller components. So Kp of Et plus Ki integration of Et dt plus Kd into B by Et of Et. Now if I take the Laplace transform, then Ms is equal to Kp plus Ki by S plus Kd into S. Yes. So if I take the Ki common, then you can write like this. Okay, so that is the equation of PID controller. So in this topic, what we have learned, we have learned some industrial control system components types. So industrial automatic controllers are there: two position or on-off controller, proportional controller, integral controller. Proportional plus integral controller, proportional plus derivative controller, proportional plus derivative plus integral controller. So these are the types of automatic controllers. These are the types of automatic controllers. Now let me show you. Okay, now let me show you some other things. Some example of PID controller. Okay, I do show you that. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is typical demonstration of a PID controller controlling the angular position of the shaft of a DC motor. It was designed as a teaching tool to show the effects of proportional integral derivative control schemes as well as the effect of saturation into interrupt and controller update rate on stability over shear stress. See this. The power of nothing happening. say proportional control KP200 desired position see it doesn't it is a gain KP500 now it's better it perform better KP1000 it's almost perfect. See, if you change the gain, TD control, KD500, KD255. Seriously, there is okay. This error. KP400 KI controller. Chief terms KP500 KI375 KP50. So I'm including up. You can up to this. Proportional controller. First, proportional controller.
Welcome back, and thank you for checking out this latest video brought to you by RealParts. Today, you will learn about PIDs, specifically what they are and when you will use them in automation and PLCs. Before we get into today's video, if you love our videos, be sure to click the like button below and make sure to click subscribe for proportional integral derivative. If you need to keep something constant, like a temperature, for example, then this is the way to do it. Essentially, it uses a control loop feedback to ensure the output wanted is what you will get. Simply, you put a setting in the controller and it will keep the output constant based on feedback from some input, typically some kind of sensor. Something you probably encounter every day that is essentially PID control is your cruise control in your vehicle. First, you get to the speed that you want to be going. Then you set your cruise control. The cruise control sends output signals to your throttle to regulate the speed. A speed sensor provides your control loop feedback to tell the cruise if the car should speed up or slow down, or how much more or less throttle to provide. A common standalone type that we use in manufacturing and industry is a temperature controller PID. These controllers are pretty simple to use and set up. Plus, they do a great job at controlling temperatures of a variety of equipment. Let's take a look at how they work. For our example, we will look at a PID controller that controls the temperature of heat tracing when process piping. First, we need to enter a set point, 200 degrees Fahrenheit for our example. Now, the controller will give a signal to the output to start heating up the heat tracing. The control loop feedback is in the form of a thermocouple to read the temperature. For our example, the PID controller can work as an on-off control for the heat tracing. Along with the set point of 200 degrees, we will set the controller at a couple of degrees above and below 200 as well. When the thermocouple reads 202 degrees, it will turn the heat tracing off. When it reads 198, it will turn it back on. This is the simplest form of PID control. We also have the option of setting up a PID controller with a PLC. Instead of the standalone unit, we can use the input and output cards already on our PLC. The process variable for control loop feedback would be wired to our input card and programmed into the PID. Our output being controlled is wired to our output card. The PID and the PLC can do all of the math and make the decisions based on the variables and set points. Which way you decide to set it up, a PID is an excellent choice for an automated process. Let's look back at today's information. A PID controller is a proportional integral derivative controller. It can keep an automated process like temperature, pressure, or flow constant for you automatically. PIDs use a control loop feedback or process variable to monitor where the output should be. These usually come in the form of sensors and meters. PIDs come in many different forms, including standalone units and PLC programming. We can use our input and output cards along with programming software to set up a PID. I hope this video really helps you get a grasp of how to use a PID. They are a very handy tool to use. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe so you never miss another Real Cars video.
Okay, so we have discussed, we have seen how we do use the PID controller. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think you have